Welcome back to another exploration of everything cinema. Thank you for choosing Man Cinema Reviews. It is your lovely host, Peter Man. What's up, y'all? On today's episode, we're gonna be reviewing the latest written and directed action thriller from Taylor Sheridan, Those Who Wish Me Dead, starring the illustrious Angelina Jolie. Let's get straight to it. In Hot Pursuit, a father, Owen, played by Jake Weber, and his son, Connor, played by newcomer Finn Little, are ruthlessly being hunted down by two hitmen, played by Nicholas Hoult and Aidan Gillen. When the hitmen catch up to them, Connor sees his father brutally gunned down from afar. Now hiding in the woods, Connor must escape the clutches of these two hitmen with the help of a nearby smoke jumper in Hannah, played by Angelina Jolie. What I gotta say is that the film's events play out in a straightforward manner, and it's at the strong helm of Taylor Sheridan. He really gets to the salient events quick. He's in, he's out. And with Angelina Jolie, this is a perfect action vehicle that could lead to a possible franchise that I think is very pertinent at this trajectory in her film career. I really do want to see her direct more, but I think this is something that she can sink her teeth in, and she is casted well opposite her burgeoning young talent here in Finn Little. Now, the supporting cast is good. We have some great key standout roles here. Especially with John Bernthal playing a very meaty performance. It's a very pivotal role as the local sheriff in the area that will help out. He does have a pregnant wife, and these are kind of the subplots to the film. And it doesn't get muddled too much, but therein lies some problems. Before I get to the cons of this film, I do want to highlight the more of a cameo in Tyler Perry making such a surprisingly show-stealing performance in this film. I don't want to give too much away, but he just has this looming, threatening appearance here. And the scene really is a credit to the film. Now with the cons, I'm going to say this film has a tad bit problem with its pacing here. It's disjointed. It has too many subplots and side character motivations that don't get fully fleshed out and is poorly executed. The main antagonists here don't make for a credible nor really believable duo. Not taking anything away from these two actors, which I hold in high regards, Aidan Gillen just is usually top-notch in these ruthless villains, and he's charismatic in most of the work that he does. In this, he plays it so stoically straight that it just comes off as boring here. Hoult usually is a charismatically shy actor. He really breaks out in his roles, playing it in his pocket. And in this film, it just doesn't seem as a believable, ruthless villain. Even though his attempts are genuine. I also gotta say that the CGI here of the blistering rapid fire, forest fires, just look cheap. And don't get me started on the lightning bolt sequences. It's just really mind-boggling how it's just poorly executed here, and it comes off as, again, cheap. I also have to say that with Taylor Sheridan, as of recently, he started off with such a strong trajectory. His writing credits included Sicario and Hell or High Water. I was thoroughly impressed with his directorial debut in Wind River back in 2017. With his latest works behind the writing credits of Sicario, Dia de Soldado, and the recent Without Remorse, his follow-up to Wind River is very, very disappointing. I just find it just pales in comparison to all of his earlier works, and it just doesn't really work. It doesn't really being fleshed out here in a credible way. I have to say that I was thoroughly disappointed with this film, and Man Cinema Reviews rates it a meager 1 star. Doesn't mean Taylor Sheridan can't bounce back from this. he just needs to with his follow-up. Thank you very much for choosing Mad Cinema Reviews. Please continue to comment, subscribe, and we'll see you on the next one.